We also want to show you some new video that we have this morning. This is of an explosion on an airfield in Lutsk. It's in the west of the country. That's and so keep cool. in mind, this is much further to the west than what we have seen so far in terms of Russia attacks in Ukraine. This is one of two airfields that were targeted in just the last 24 hours. Joining us now is CNN military analyst, retired Colonel Cedric Leighton. He's going to walk us through what we're seeing here. And specifically, Colonel, as we start with that, with these attacks on airfields, the bombardment in the west and then also in Dnipro, as we just heard about from Sam Kiley, what do you make of that strategy on the part of Russia?
Well, Erica, good morning. The big thing that the Russians are doing here is attacking airfields, Lutsk and Ivano-Frankivsk, that are really close to the Polish and Slovakian and Hungarian borders. What they're doing, in my view, is in this part of their campaign, is interdicting or getting ready to interdict as many supplies that come from the West into Ukraine. So they're trying to stop the supplies that we're sending from the NATO countries into Ukraine. They're trying to stop them from getting to Ukrainian forces and the Ukrainian defenders. What is happening in Dnipro right here in the center that Sam Kiley was reporting on, that is an area where they can basically cut the country in two. I've always looked at Dnipro as being a place that is kind of an axis that they can turn on. So they can move forces from the south, they can move forces from the northeast, and they can move, once they get Dnipro, they can then move those forces up the Dnipro River Valley toward Kyiv. So this is a critical juncture for them as well. So what they're doing here is moving this whole operation to the entire country, and they're trying to make it very hard for the Ukrainians to defend themselves.
Yeah, those missile strikes in the west set off the air raid sirens here in Lviv overnight and again this morning. Cedric, we just were speaking about those new satellite images of that stalled Russian convoy we've been following for a number of days. Now it appears to have dispersed. Can you tell us what that means? Does that mean they were able to move it along, or they're just hiding?
Well, first of all, it's, you know, Jim, this is, I think, a place where they're hiding some things, but they're maybe hiding them to position things like multiple rocket launchers in residential areas. So this is a favorite Russian tactic in case they are attacked by somebody. What they're trying to do is they're trying to move their vehicles from a road-type situation where they can, where you can kind of see some of the vehicles on the roads, to a situation where they actually are hidden in the trees. And in this particular case, if you look very carefully, you can see that these vehicles are emplaced right in the tree line right here. It's not a good dispersal because, you know, from imagery we can tell that these vehicles and weapon systems are still there, but it is a movement away from the roads so that they're less vulnerable to attack, either from air attack or from drone attack, and that's the kind of thing that that they're very much looking to do at this point, Jim.
You know, we've also had a really heavy focus on Mariupol under heavy bombardment, as we know, this week. The situation there is dire. Officials say food, water running out. Just walk us through, once again, remind us why Russia is so interested in Mariupol, the strategic importance of this city.
Absolutely, Erica. Mariupol is on the Sea of Azov right here. This is a body of water that is very important to the Russians. They, in essence, want to make this a lake, but there's a reason for it. It's not just because they like this lake. What they want is they want to control Mariupol, which is right here, because that provides a land bridge between Crimea, which they've annexed, and the Donbas region, which is this area right here. And this area controlled by the separatists, this area controlled by the Russians, this area now with Russian troops in it, all of this is key to their plan to cut off Ukraine from the sea. So that's the eastern part of that plan. The western part is over here where the city of Odessa is. That is another part of the plan, but for Mariupol, that's a key to making sure that they, from their standpoint, pacify this region and make it really completely Russian. That's what their goal is at this point.
NATO is, as you know, discussing now sending advanced air defense systems to Ukraine. No-fly zone really off the table, even those jets from Poland off the table. But I've been told by senior military officials that these air defense systems are really what the Ukrainian military needs now. Can you describe what kind of weapons we're talking about?
Sure. One of those weapons, Jim, is the S-400. This is a mobile surface-to-air missile. This is the one that people have been talking about when it comes to NATO countries like Turkey, for example, actually getting Russian equipment. The key thing about that, Jim, is that if the S-400 were employed by Turkey, it could potentially provide the Russians with information on U.S. aircraft signatures. So this is a particularly impressive weapon system because what it does is it has a range of up to 400 kilometers, basically 250 miles. It has two battalions. The Russians have two battalions of S-400s in Belarus. So that goes back to the idea of they are controlling the airspace in and around Ukraine. Now, if the Ukrainians were to get S-400s, which is also a possibility, they could use those to make sure that Russian aircraft don't target them as freely as they've been able to target them, and especially their cities right now. So the S-400 is a road mobile weapon system that is very modern, and it is also capable of going potentially after stealth aircraft. So any country that has this has a very potent weapon in its arsenal.
So wait, Cedric, you're saying that NATO's thinking of sending a Russian anti-aircraft system to the Ukrainian military?
There is a possibility of that. Some of the NATO countries do have these air defense systems in their arsenals, and that is one possibility to get this Russian system into Ukraine and use it against against the Russians in this scenario.
Interesting. Colonel Cedric Leighton, thanks for walking us all through it.